everybody, it's Dr. Joe. And Brian, he's going to be my model today to show you the speeds test to test for biceps tendonitis. So let's get started. Disclaimer alert, disclaimer alert. So for the speeds test, you're checking for that biceps tendonitis up here in that groove, that bicipital groove. Just remember, these special tests can be false positive, they can be false negative. So just because it's positive doesn't necessarily mean that's what it is. I just use it as a stepping tool to find out specifically what's going on, because this test could cause pain if there's a rotator cuff tear or if there's an impingement. So don't take it completely at face value, because like I said, there are some false positives and false negatives. Just use it in your tools to narrow down what's going on. So for the speeds test, what you want to do is have them put their arms straight out. You want their elbow to be completely extended, so no bend in there, as straight as they can possibly get it. Start with it in that neutral position with the thumb up on top. And then as they're holding it there, you want to find that groove. And the groove is pretty easy to find. It's a groove. And if they haven't had any surgery to move that bicep tendon, where they probably wouldn't have pain there anymore because it's gone, you can feel a little cord. You can feel that bicep tendon in there. And so if he's got a lot of tendonitis on that tendon, just pushing on it, probably going to hurt a little bit. So sometimes you don't have to go all the way through the test, just kind of feel around in there. And does it hurt? You don't have anything. So you can push pretty hard. I'm pushing pretty hard in there. And so if they're not having any pain, then go ahead through the test. So the first part, after you get their arm straight out, you want to go into supinated. There you go. That's the positive test right there. And usually if they're going to have pain, it's going into that supination, opening up that hand like you're holding a cup of soup. And then if they're maybe having a little bit of pain, then go into pronation and check with that one as well. But keep that pressure on that tendon the whole time. I'm keeping pressure on it, right? Yeah. So that's all you do, going into supination and then turning back into pronation while you're pushing around on that tendon. And so there's tenderness, pain, that's a positive test. Sometimes you can relax that. You might feel it trying to jump out of the groove if it's really unstable in there. So those are the positives for it. But again, remember, if it's not biceps tendonitis, it still might be painful. So don't just take it as that's what it is because that test was positive. So if you'd like some stretches and exercises for that, if you got a positive test, make sure you click up here. And if you'd like to help support my channel, find out by clicking that link up there. And don't forget to subscribe. Where do we go? Down there. And remember, be safe. Make sure it stays in that groove. Have fun. And I hope you feel better soon.